Leave a like on this video within the next 5 seconds if you want 2K to finally bring down the price of VC. 2K has been trying to raise the price of everything. They can't raise the price of VC, man. It's a big deal. If anything, they need to be bringing it down. So if you guys want 2K to finally bring down the price of VC, leave a like.
I got digital dash, can't ride with a art. I walk in the store and I buy the stock. I hide in the bins and pull out the lot. Got Tiffany diamond, it cost me a lot. They flying like birds, but drop on this hot. 400 degrees, I burned up the block. Burn out, make one call, they turn out. CC the gang, get the word out. When the shit getting hot, you the first out. Cover my wrist with a watch and I flood it with rocks. Now I look at the time all day. Be how I ride through your block and I drop off the top. And I know you can see my face. You my dog at the end, don't care what the bitches say.
I got this dash, can't ride with a heart. I walk in the store and I buy the stock. I hop in the Benz and pull up.
Alright, before we go too far into this video, I want to make sure to go over this. Now, we were at 4.2%. We're all the way up to 9.7%. But still, 90% of y'all that are watching my videos aren't even subscribed. I know y'all mess with the videos. We finna be going so crazy, so you might as well hit that sub button. Is that simple? Yo, what's YouTube? It's your boy Fizz back with yet another video. Today I'm coming at you guys with the builds with the most badges at every single position on next gen NBA 2K21. And now we know on next gen a lot of these builds get a lot more badges than we've ever seen. There's literally a build that gets 101 badge grades, and that's even before you even hit legend. Now, for this video, I did do builds that did not have physicals, but for the next time, if you guys want me to do with physicals attributes, I can do the builds with the most badges with max physicals. I can literally do that next time. But for this one, I'm gonna be doing the most badges possible on every single build, and you obviously don't get badges for physicals, so I didn't touch physicals. But yeah, so I don't think these builds are usable, but it's still gonna be showing y'all because I think it's gonna be an entertaining video. But yeah, put in the comments down below any ideas you guys want me to do. Leave a like on this video if you haven't already. Subscribe if you're new. But yeah, man, without further ado, let's go ahead and hop straight into it.
Let's go!
All right, so for the point guard position, a lot of these builds, I'm going to say this right now, a lot of these builds are going to be very, very similar into the way they are made. The main thing you need to be focusing on is how many bad upgrades we get on each single build. So for the point guard, we're going to end up with 28 finishing, 12 shooting, 20 playmaking, and 25 defensive rebounding. So the height, weight, wingspan, very similar on all these builds, I'm going to be honest. 6'7", 189 pounds, and 7'4". So if you're making a build like that, you want to get as many badges as possible, you can do that pretty much at any position, and you're going to be able to pretty much make the most badge possible build that you can possibly make. Now, on this build, you're going to be taking a lot of hits on a lot of different places, mainly physicals. Like I said, we're not really focused on physicals because that doesn't really get you badge grades. But if you want to get a lot of badge grades, you're going to get a lot of badge grades from defensive rebounding, for the steal, block, offensive rebound, and defense rebound. Pretty much everything on playmaking had to go up. Shooting, mid-range, and three-pointer, close shot, driving layup, driving dunk, and standing dunk, pretty much. And that's pretty much how you make this build to get how many badge amounts or badge upgrades that I actually ended up going with. Then for the takeovers, you don't really get spot of precision, though. That's a pretty easy choice for me. I'm gonna go with finishing moves and ankle breaking shots. And the build came out as an offensive threat. So yeah, man, that's going to be the first build that's around 85 badge upgrades. And trust me, we're gonna get more and more. But 85 badge upgrades on a point guard build, that's actually not bad. All right, next is going to be the shooting guard position. Now, for the shooting guard position, it's going to be one less. It's going to be around 85, but I think it's 84. And the way that you're going to be making it is very similar. You're going to be 6'7", 189 pounds, and 7'4". Actually, it's going to be the exact same. Then when it comes to the attributes, you're going to pretty much do it the exact same. And this is going to be the best way to get the most badges possible on this build. You're going to get 27 finishing, 12 shooting, 20 playmaking, and 25 defensive rebounding. Now, when it comes to this build, you're going to have holes. Obviously, that's going to be physical, so I'm not telling y'all to make this build. This is just the pretty much the best things to put up to be able to get badge upgrades on your build. Now, if you wanted to go with physicals, an easy way to get physicals is lowering your close shot. If I put close shot up, if you lower your close shot, that's going to be a very, very simple and easy way to be able to put physicals up. Because if you don't know, close shot actually, that takes a lot into play on your overall. So If you want to get that up, that's going to be important. Now, another thing that's important for guards that I'm not putting up is perimeter defense. It just takes too big of a hit on your overall, so I just can't put that up at point guard, shooting guard when it comes to going for badges. So that's another reason why this is not a viable build for actually trying to play with. This is just strictly for going for badges. Now, when it comes to the takeovers I ended up going with, finishing moves and ankle breaking shots, those are going to be the two most fun takeovers. So those are the takeovers I end up going with, and the build comes out as an offensive threat, similar to shades of Zach LaVine, Clyde Drexler, and Luka Doncic. And now for the small four. So for the small four, we're actually going to be at 6'7", 217, and 7'4" on the wingspan. Now, the way that you're going to be making it is very similar yet again when it comes to the attributes. Now, you're going to have 24 finishing, 14 shooting, 25 playmaking, and 24 defensive this time. So this is going to be more and more around towards like 90 badge upgrades. Still not as close as we're going to get to like for the max, but it's still going to be a lot of badges. Still the same, but you're still going to be upgrading pretty much the same thing. Close shot, driving layup, driving dunk, standing dunk, mid-range three, free throw, everything on playmaking. Steal, block, offensive rebound, and defensive rebound, and still not touching anything on your physicals. Now, when it comes to making builds on this game, you're going to need a lot of this stuff that I'm not putting up. Perimeter defense, physicals, you're going to need pretty much all that. So that's why another reason I'm going to keep saying this. None of these builds are very viable. It's literally just showing you guys what's the best thing to upgrade at these positions with these height, weight, wingspan, and showing you guys what's going to be the most upgrades you can get possible. That's why I asked you guys in the intro, did you guys want me to drop this exact video but with physicals, which I can do later. That's not hard to do, but yeah, that's still gonna have a lot of builds with no perimeter defense still, so I don't know if those builds are even gonna be 100% viable at that point. But yeah, this is actually, you know what I'm saying, it's starting to get more and more bad degrades on the builds. But yeah, the build for the takeovers, we end up going with the same takeover, finishing moves, ankle breaking shots, and then the build comes out as a, again, offensive threat, but actually this time we get a similar two of a GOAT, LeBron James. Yeah, man, that's going to be the most badges on a small four build. And for the power four, we all know how overpowered the power fours are. If there's anything that this video is going to show you, it's going to show you pretty much what's the most badges you can get per position. Pretty much all the positions are very balanced. The small four, like I said at the beginning of the year when I dropped the build tips, I thought small four got the most badges until I tried to make a power four build. Power four builds get by far the most badges. And when you see the difference between point guard, shooting guard, small four, and center, you will understand why people are making so many more power fours. Now, for the power four, we're going to go with a very, very similar height, weight, wingspan. But when it comes to this build, you actually end up with 26, 22, 28, and 25. I uploaded a video on this build. I'm going to be updating it and showing you guys with attributes for the physicals to show y'all like the most badges you can get with physicals. So stay tuned for that. But yeah, I've already shown you guys this on the channel. Just know that. So what you're going to end up with, that's the badge upgrades. And then when it comes to upgrading it, it's pretty similar to the way you upgraded. The only thing that we didn't do that we did on the other ones, we pretty much went max on playmaking every single time. This one, we lowered our speed ball, and that allowed us to get even more badge upgrades on everything else. So that pretty much made our build very, very well rounded. Now, this is actually not a bad build at all, but like I was saying, like the difference between this build and the other ones, the small four had around 90. The shooting guard and power, shooting guard and point guard, they both had around 85. This build has 101 badge upgrades, so that's 10 more than the small four and over 15 more than the shooting guard and point guard. So that just pretty much shows you guys how overpowered the power fours are in comparison to the point guard, shooting guard, small four, and center. I'm just showing y'all that this because this is actually very important when it comes to making builds. A lot of people still don't have the game, so for the people that's not made a build yet, just know, do not waste your time trying to make builds at these other positions. If you're going to go 6'7" or above, just make it at a power four. It's that simple. It's just the simplest thing to do. Then when it comes to the takeovers, I end up going with finishing moves and spotted precision. And the build comes out as an offensive threat build, similar to Chris Webber, John Wall, or not John Wall, John Collins, and Jason Tatum. And last but not least, now this build actually gets a lot of bad degrees. It gets more than a point guard and shooting guard. Now, originally, I thought centers and small fours was going to get a lot more, but we went over that. Power fours gets literally 10 more than either one of these, but this gets more than the point guard, shooting guard for sure. Now, for this build, you're actually going to go 6'9", because you can't go any shorter than 6'9". The reason you want to go 6'7" is because you're going to have such a higher ball handle and speed ball, which is going to allow you to get more playmaking badges. But with this, it's not going to really matter, and to be honest. And then when it comes to things like weight and wingspan, I could have lowered the free throw to be able to take less, but like it was really hard to get the perfect free throw for this build. So if I really would have got the perfect free throw, I feel like I might be able to get more badges, but this is the most I could get at the time of me recording this video. And this is 91 badge upgrades. So you're going to end up with 20 finishing, 26 shooting, 25 playmaking, and 20 defensive rebound badges. That's a lot of badges. 91. Now, is it 101? No, but like I feel like just the power field, the power four builds, they're just broken. They're not balanced at all. That's really just on 2K, just not balancing the game. It's not really on nobody else. That's just on 2K. That's just is what it is at this point. But if you want to make a 6'9" build, this is actually a good, like, well-rounded, bad 6'9" build. Now, is it a build that you can take to the park? No, you don't have no physicals. You know what I'm saying? So like, you don't have no interior defense. It's not. You know what I'm saying? It's just a thing that these, it's a lot of things on this build that are missing to be able to get more badges. So you gotta understand that. But like I said, on the power forward, this is just really showing you guys pretty much what's gonna get more badges than other builds, or what positions are gonna get more badges than other builds. But yeah, that's going to be pretty much the build. And then the takeover I end up going with is finishing moves and fire precision. I went over that yesterday. Those are the two best badges in the game. I'm gonna be re-ranking these and going over in more detail what these takeovers really do. But yeah, stay tuned for that. And the build comes out as a playmaking 3-level score, similar to shades of the GOAT, Bam Adebayo, Karl-Anthony Towns, and Andre Drummond. So yeah, man, that's going to be pretty much the most badges on a center build in this game. Now, if you look back at this, point guard had 85, shooting guard had 84, small forward had 90 or 91, power forward had 101, and center had 91 badge upgrades. If you've seen builds with more badge upgrades at these positions, just let me know. I'm not going to be offended. It just makes it more interesting. I really just went into the game and just tried my hardest to find the most badges I could find. And it took me a long time to make this video, so if you haven't already, please drop a like on this video. If you enjoy, subscribe. If you knew we do this every single day, turn on post notifications. Be the first to every single my video. Share this video with anybody you think this will help. But yeah, like I said at the beginning of this video, if you guys want me to do this video but with actual physicals so that you can actually use these builds, just go ahead and let me know that down in the comments. But left and hitting this, I got a couple videos left. We got the animation videos, we got the rarest builds, the most overpowered builds. We got all that still to go and hit me. So if you guys want that to come out as soon as possible, go ahead, hit the like button, subscribe if you're new. We on the road to 100K, so I really would appreciate it. But yeah, man, it's your boy Fist Man, and I'm out the bit, man.
Tell them to bring me my money.
Yeah! Head in the clouds, walk through the city, they taking you out. Bitches be talking, they running, they mouth. A bag in the back and a stick in the couch. You know what it's about. Had to cope with all the pain, so I'm about to die. Amen. They say he going too fast.